Good evening, Paul.
Good evening.
Praise God. Meron para tayong Girl Scout dito. Hallelujah. Can you stand up, please? Thank you. Joke lang. Praise the Lord. Thank you, Father God. Thank you. I love you, Heidi. God is good. You know, in Jeremiah 5:22, it talks about the power of God. Because, see, every time I pray, I have to know who I'm talking to. I have to know, you know, I'm settled in my heart and I'm confident in my heart that God is all-powerful. And when we pray, we should have that in our heart, because then if we don't know who our God is, it's hard to pray. It's hard to have faith. But if you go to Jeremiah 5:22, the Lord says there that he set a boundary, a sand. He set the sand as a boundary where the water won't pass. He said, even though the waves roll, it cannot pass. It will not prevail. Even though the waters roar, the waters will not pass. Imagine the power of God. When you meditate on the Word of God, on how powerful He is, any problem, any trial that we go through, we will understand that we serve a powerful God. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. This is the God that set the sand so that the waters will not pass. Amen. Amen. God is good. Father God, we welcome your holy presence. The same power, Father God, that set the sand so that the waters will not pass. Father God, we believe that same power is present here. Father God, I pray that the power of God, your holy power, Father God, will break every bondage tonight in the name of Jesus. I pray that that same power will deliver people from the problems and trials that they are going through. Father God, have your way in our lives, Father God, in the name of Jesus.
Yes, Lord.
You are God. Yes, Father God, you are the living God. Father God, I pray that you would use our pastors to minister with power, Father God, with conviction in the name of Jesus. Again, I pray that they would not be dull of hearing spiritually, that what you want to happen tonight, Father God, I pray that your will be done. Have your way, Father God. Thank you, Jesus. Let us all stand. Thank you, Father God. You are worthy to be praised.
Amen.
You are worthy to be praised. We glorify you. We honor you. No man, no woman, Father God, will be glorified. Only the name of Jesus. Thank you, Lord.
Hallelujah. Yes, God. We worship you, Lord God. There is none like you. You are the God of ages. You are the same yesterday, today, and forever. You're a God who lives, the God who heals, and you are our hope. Lord, we love you. We bless you. Hallelujah. We worship the Lord God in the mighty name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Clap your hands. Amen. He's the God of ages. Yes, Lord, our hope is in you. Hallelujah.
God of ages, bringing glory here. You are good, you are good. Son of righteousness, you are all I see. With all my heart, giver of life. life. Hope for the lost is in you. All of the earth shines with your light, your glory.
Come on, let's see there.
You are the God who lives. You are the God who heals. You are my hope, my everything.
You brought salvation.
You brought salvation to us. Offer your peace to the world. You are my hope, my everything.
Yes, Lord. Oh, we worship you. We lift your name on high. Yeah.
Your promise and your faithfulness, I will trust all my days. King forever, reign in majesty, be glorified. Life. Hope of the lost is in you. Shout up, shine with your light, your glory.
You are the God.
You are the God who lives. You are the God who heals. You are my hope, my from salvation to us. Offer your peace to the world. You are my hope, my everything.
You are the God of ages.
And you are the God who heals. You are the God who heals. You are my hope, my
you brought salvation.
You brought salvation to us. Offer your peace to the world. You are my hope, my everything. I'll trust in you. I'll trust in you. I'll trust in you. With all my heart.
Come on, sing it again.
I'll trust in you. I'll trust in you. I'll trust in you. With all my heart. You are the God who heals. You are the God who lives. You are my hope, my end.
You brought salvation.
Salvation to us. Offer your peace to the world. And you are my hope, my everything.
I trust in you.
I trust in you. I trust in you. I trust in you. With all my heart,
I trust in you.
I'll trust in you.
Yes, Lord.
I'll trust in you. I'll trust in you. With all my heart.
Sing it again. Trust in you.
I'll trust in you. I'll trust in you. I'll trust in you with all my heart.
Hallelujah. We trust in you. Amen. Hallelujah. Lord, our trust is in you because you are a great and mighty God. Father, we thank you. We look to you tonight, Lord God. Jesus, the name that is above every name. Hallelujah.
Father God, so many times you said in the Bible that you are always with us, Lord God. And Lord, we pray, Father God, that you let your presence be known tonight, Lord God. We ask that you reveal yourself to us tonight, Lord God, as we worship your beautiful, awesome name, Lord God.
Yours is the kingdom, yours is the glory.
every name. Jesus, come on, clap your hands. Hallelujah. Yes, Lord, your name is greater. Hallelujah. We worship you. Let's continue to praise the name of Jesus. Let praises rise.
Praises rise.
I want is you.
All I want is for you, for you to be glorified, for you to be lifted high. All I want is for you.
Fire, Lord God,
from the inside.
That's our prayer, Lord God. Fill this place, Lord, as we surrender to you, Lord God.
Oh, yes, Jesus. Fill us, Lord. Fill us with your fire. Oh, God. Oh Lord,
as we worship you, let praises rise. Just praise the name of Jesus. Hallelujah.
Oh, we praise you. We praise the name of Jesus. Hallelujah.
Worthy. You are our God and we are your people. And Lord, we surrender to you tonight. We humble ourselves, Lord God, knowing that without you we are nothing. Lord, we thank you for your spirit. We thank you for your fire, Lord God, filling every heart and mind tonight, Lord God. Jesus, we thank you. Yes, thank you, Lord God, for what you have done. Thank you, Jesus, for your name, the name that is above every name. Beautiful name, powerful name, wonderful name of Jesus. We lift up the name of Jesus. Our hope is trust is the name of Jesus. Come on, clap your hands. Woo! Hallelujah. God, we bless you. We bless you. In the mighty name of Jesus. Amen and amen. Amen.
Good evening, Senyong Lahat. Welcome to tonight's service. God is good. Amen. God is good. Amen. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. It's always good to be in His presence. It's always good to be amongst brethren. When I say brethren, I'm talking about sisters as well. So, wag kayo ma-offend mga sisters. Brothers din kayo. Brethren, it's always good to be together in God's house worshiping God. Amen. Amen. So, this afternoon or this evening, let's first welcome our visitors before we continue. when I call your name, kung pwede po kayo lumapit dito sa harapan, we have something that we'd like to give you. We also would like to pray for you. So let's first welcome Rain Malaka. Rain Malaka, nasaan si Rain? Please come forward and see Rain. And then we also have Regina. Tatay Simplicio. Tatay, nasaan si Tatay Simplicio? Nasaan siya? Where are you? Ayun, si Tatay. Dito po kayo. Meron pang iba na hindi namin nakuha yung name, first time here. We'd like to pray for you. And we also have something we want to give you. So kung first time nyo ngayon, pwede kayo lumapit dito sa harapan. Meron pa ba? Wala na? Okay, so welcome to our service tonight. Welcome po. God bless you po. And meron po kaming bibigay sa inyo card. So ito po, thank you card. So ibig sabihin na, we thank you for coming. And we want to bless you with prayer. Pagkatapos ko pang pray para sa inyo, yan po si Brother Marlon doon. Meron pa siya ibibigay sa inyo. So, mamaya, after we pray, punta kayo sa kanya, and he will also give you a Bible kung wala kayong Bible, okay? Church, let us extend our hands and pray for them. Father, once again, we want to thank you, Lord, for bringing, Lord God, visitors, family, friends, Lord God, to this place, Lord God, to be in your presence, Lord God, and to grow, Lord God, in their knowledge and in their relationship with you, Lord God. We pray, Lord God, in the name of Jesus, na ikaw po ang kumilo sa kanilang buhay, Lord God. Lord, kung ano man yung mga needs nila, whatever they are seeking, Lord God, searching for, we pray, Lord God, that you would show them, Lord God, the way, Lord God. We thank you, Lord God, again for bringing them here, Lord God. We welcome them into this place, Lord God, bilang family, Lord God, the family of God. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Manalangin po tayo. Let us pray. Father, we thank you for this evening. We thank you, Father, for your presence in our lives. Tonight, Father, we lift up our nation. And we pray, Father, for the outpouring of your Spirit upon this nation. We pray, Father, that you would intervene. Lord, that your will be done sa aming bansa, Panginoon. Father, we lift up our president. We lift up those that are leading this nation. And we pray that you would bless them with wisdom. That you would bless them with the ability to make the right decisions for this nation. We pray, Father, that your presence would be upon their lives. We ask your guidance, Panginoon, in every decision they make, be it concerning this nation or even their personal lives. Father, we pray that they would seek your face. Father, we lift up their families, and we pray for your protection upon their families and those that work for them. Father, above all, we ask that they would be saved. We pray for their salvation, Father, in the name of Jesus. Pagpalain mo ang bansang Pilipinas, Panginoon. Bless this nation, we pray. We pray, Father, for your blessing on this province, this city, Panginoon. Pour out your Spirit, we pray. Father, we also lift up the church in this nation, that we would believe together for this nation and work together to exalt Jesus Christ in this nation. Father, we pray for the unity of the body of Christ in this nation, Panginoon, inclusive of the different mission organizations, the different church or parachurch organizations, Panginoon. And Father, we ask that you would bind us together. This evening, Lord, we remember Pastor John Corcoran, Panginoon, and we pray for your healing upon his life. We pray, Father God, that you would strengthen his physical body and that you would strengthen his faith. Father, we pray that you would provide every need that they have regarding the treatment that needs to be done and the medication. Panginoon, we ask for wisdom upon the family. And also that even tonight, at this moment, that they would be encouraged by your Spirit. Thank you, Father. Father, we remember Karis Asban, Panginoon, and we pray for your divine healing upon her life. Bless her. Strengthen her even as she goes for a CT scan tomorrow. We ask, Father, that everything would show exactly what they need to do, Panginoon, sa mga procedures that need to be done soon. We pray that you would provide for their needs as well. Father, we give you praise, O God. Salamat po, Jesus. Brothers and sisters, please join hands. And as you do so, let's just pray for one another. Manalangin po tayo sa bawat isa tonight. Father, we thank you for family. We thank you for the church. And we thank you for friends, Panginoon. And we ask that you would bless one another, bless each and every person that is here tonight by your Spirit. Salamat po, Panginoon. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. And amen. Good evening po sa inyo. Let's give God a clap of praise. So for our announcements tonight, we'll forego the regular announcements. Alam niyo naman yun. But number one, please do place your mobile devices on silent mode during the service. Also, on Wednesday night, we have a Bible study, the service, and we will be talking about hungering and thirsting for righteousness. So join us on Wednesday at 7 o'clock hanggang 8:30 in the evening. And then on Saturday is our happy home, pero I'll explain that in a moment. My announcement for November 26th is our family, our Thanksgiving gathering. Yan po yung gaganapin sa WOW Swimming Pool. It'll be a Saturday, 3 o'clock in the afternoon. It will be a fair. Ibig sabihin, we'll have booths and we'll have games and it'll be a time of fellowship. It'll also be a potluck time. So bring your own food and tayo po, we're going to share food with one another. That is on November 26th. At 3 o'clock in the afternoon at the WOW Swimming Pool. And also, if you want to be baptized in water this year, please register with our ushers. Kasi the day before, which is a Friday, November 25, magkakaroon po tayo ng teaching. That is 6:30 in the afternoon here at church. There'll be a teaching on water baptism. And then the following day, Saturday, you will be baptized in water. So yan lamang po announcements regarding this. Now, Happy Home 2 is an outreach we do. This is our second time. We are reaching out to the PWD, otherwise known as Persons with Disability. It is a government organization. And itong mga to, they will bring their families and they'll bring them to church. That is this coming Saturday, October 29, at 3 o'clock in the 2 o'clock ba? 2 o'clock in the afternoon. Dito po gaganapin. So we ask that you would pray. Kasi this Saturday, we're going to be reaching out to them and their families. We cannot invite you to come kasi we are expecting over 150 of them to come and join us and hear the gospel of Jesus Christ. So among the 150, we also have about 50 youth that will be here. So we'll have about 200 people here on Saturday. Kaya maigi po, just pray for us. Stay home and pray for us. But if you need to get involved, you want to get involved, talk to Brother Ali regarding that. We will be broadcasting live as well. So if you want to know what's happening on October 29, Saturday, you can watch us live. So yun lamang po announcements. Also, please do, we're still accepting donations of food, clothing, toys and anything up until Thursday.
And so we'll be doing again this year. It will be like Pastor Jimmy shared, October 29. This evening, we'll be having communion. So the children will stay with us. So we'll have children's service tonight. So children stay with their parents and we will receive communion. So before we receive communion this evening, I would like to share a message about communion. I'll be reading a few scriptures which I wasn't able to put on the slide for you, but please do listen. In Colossians chapter 2, verse 11 to verse 15, it says, "When you came to Christ, you were circumcised, but not by a physical procedure. Christ performed a spiritual circumcision, the cutting away of your sinful nature. For you were buried with Christ when you were baptized, and with him you were raised to new life because you trusted the mighty power of God who raised Christ from the dead. You were dead because of your sins and because your sinful nature was not yet cut away. When God made you alive with Christ, then God made you alive with Christ, for he forgave all our sins. He canceled the record of the charges against us and took it away by nailing it to the cross. In this way, he disarmed the spiritual rulers and authorities. He shamed them publicly by his victory over them on the cross." Now, these scriptures are very, very powerful for the life of a believer. I just want to go through them one by one and just talk about a little bit. Again, verse 11 says, "When you came to Christ, you were circumcised, but not by a physical procedure. Christ performed a spiritual circumcision, the cutting away of your sinful nature." So that sinful nature that we once had when we were not in Christ, the Bible says it was cut away. So we're no longer fighting a sinful nature. That's not the reason why we continue to sin. That's not the reason why we sin. The reason why we sin still, even as believers, and God is changing us from glory to glory. The things we used to do before, God is now changing us, and we're no longer doing that. But we're not yet perfected. The reason why we do still commit sin is not because of a sinful nature, but it's because of our imperfectness. It's just being human. That's the reason. But God is perfecting us. So remember, God says, or the Bible says, that he cut away our sinful nature. "For you were buried," verse 12, "with Christ when you were baptized, and with him you were raised to new life because you trusted the mighty power of God who raised Christ from the dead." So the old nature was cut away. Now you have new life in Christ. Bago na ang ating buhay kay Kristo. You were raised to new life in Christ. Verse 13. "You were dead because of your sins, and because of your sinful nature was not yet cut away. Then God made you alive with Christ, for he forgave all our sins." God did not forgive some of our sins. God did not forgive just the lighter, what we think is lighter sins. God forgave all of our sins, past, present, and future. It was dealt with on the cross. Verse 14. "He canceled the record of the charges against us and took it away by nailing it to the cross." Satan, our enemy, tries to condemn us, tell us in our imperfectness that we are guilty and that we deserve hell. But the Bible says that he canceled the record of the charges that was made against us. He took it away by nailing it to the cross. God declared us not guilty by nailing our sins to the cross. We are washed by his blood. His death gave us life. Though Christ was innocent, he took upon all of our sins, nailed it to the cross, died the death of one that is guilty, though he was innocent, so that we, you and I, can be proclaimed not guilty. Verse 15, "In this way, he disarmed the spiritual rulers and authorities. He shamed them publicly by his victory over them on the cross." So he disarmed spiritual leaders of darkness He disarmed them. They have no more power over you, over your life. They, Satan, and all spiritual darkness has been disarmed of power over you. You now belong to Christ. When we receive communion, we must remember the victory that Christ gained over Satan. Amen. As you receive communion, remember Christ gained victory over Satan. Christ's victory is our victory. Last Sunday, I shared how you are Christ's trophy, that God holds you in high esteem, that God is proud of you, that Christ gained you as his prize when he won victory over Satan. Understand it this way. You were the prize that Christ looked forward to when he was winning the victory, when he was gaining victory over Satan. You are that prize, that trophy that Christ was looking forward to gaining. You know, those that are involved in sports or any kind of competition, you work hard, you strive hard, you train hard so you can gain the prize. You aim for that prize. You aim for that trophy. That's what you're aiming for. When Christ came to earth, he aimed for you. You are God's trophy. You are Christ's trophy. Christ was looking forward to winning us, to winning you as his prize. He was aiming for you. And Christ went all the way to the point of death on the cross, because that's what it took for him to gain you as his prize. That is how valuable you are. That is how important you are to God. That is how important you are to Christ, that he went all the way. He did not stop in the middle. In fact, in the garden of Gethsemane, he said, "Father, if this cup can pass away, let it pass. But if not, let your will be done. Not my will, but your will be done," he said. And so he continued on, because there was no other way of gaining the prize, which is you and me. There was no other way that he could gain his prize, you and me, if not for him to die on the cross. So he went all the way. He died the death of a guilty one so that he can make us not guilty of sin, so that he can gain us. Christ gave it all to you and for you so that he might gain you. Amen. Amen. God is good. Hallelujah. God is so good. Wake up every day and remind yourself how good God is. Wake up every day and remind yourself how valuable you are in the sight of God. Amen. When you receive communion this evening, I want you to look at that. I want you to visualize that. I want you to understand that as you take it tonight. You don't take it parang feeling sorry, Lord, you died for me, parang nag-aawa pa tayo sa kanya. No. You take it understanding that he did that for you, because that's how much he loves you. That's how valuable you are. He went all the way in order that he may gain you. The Bible talks about us in a race so that we may gain Christ. He did the same for us. He did that for us before he asked us to do that for him. He went all the way. And so today, as you receive communion, church, remember how valuable you are to him. How valuable. He doesn't just love you. He sees you as valuable. That's a different thing. Because sometimes we think, oh, God loves me. Even I'm like this. Kahit ganito ako, mahal ako ng Diyos. No, no, no. You are valuable. You are precious. You are God's most precious creation. He loves you because you are valuable. Amen? Amen? So church, would you please bow your heads with me? I'm going to ask the communion ushers to please prepare the table. Thank you, Lord. Father, in the name of Jesus, Lord, as we receive communion this evening, we remember what you did on the cross. we also remember, Lord God, how valuable we are, not because of who we are, but because of what you did. You made us valuable. You made us worthy. And so, Father, today we want to thank you. We want to thank you, Jesus. Church, pause for a moment and just understand right now, no matter what you've done, no matter where you've been, you are valuable to God, and God loves you. Thank you, Father. Father, as we receive communion today, we remember the victory that was gained over Satan so that we may have life. We thank you, Father, in Jesus' name. I'm going to ask the worship team to please come and receive communion first, together with the technical team, that they will receive communion first. After they receive communion, then they will start with the first rows, followed by the second row, and so forth. Lord Jesus. Father God, once again, we thank you for this evening. And as we continue, Lord God, in tonight's service with your word, your message to us, we pray, Lord God, that you would speak to us, Lord God, in your own special way. Lord God, that we would not hear, people would not hear my voice, but we would hear your voice, Lord God. That we would hear the Spirit speak to us, Lord God. And that your word, Lord God, will become revelation to us, Lord God, and will take root in our hearts, Lord God. Something, Lord God, that we'll be able to take home with us, Lord God. Something that we can live by, Lord God. We thank you, Father, so much for all you've done. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Holy Spirit. All glory and honor, Lord, belongs to you forever and ever. In the name of Jesus, we pray. Amen. Amen. God is so good. Hallelujah. Amen. No matter how many times you say God is good, it's true. Yeah, God is good. You can't say that enough. Amen. So we don't just say it just to say it. We say it because it is absolutely true. God is good. Amen. Today is October 23. On October 25, my wife and I will be celebrating 29 years. Meron mo yan, 29 years. Amazing. God is good, amen. Sabi ng wife ko, isang araw, we were driving home. I think we were driving home. We were driving. And she said, "Dear, kailan mo ba kakantahin yung ano? When will you sing that song that I like? Lady, you're mine." Favorite niya yung song na Lady. So every time we're with friends and we have karaoke or videoke, they would ask me to sing that song. Yun lang ang alam ko eh. So Lady. Anyway. Today I'm going to share a little bit of what I shared last Sunday. And then I will add to that. So let me first read the verse that I read last Sunday. Because as I was reading that and as I was preparing the message last Sunday, and even after our service last Sunday, I myself got encouraged. Not that I'm saying that, oh, ang galing ko na encourage ko sarili ko sa sariling message ko. I'm not saying that. I was encouraged by God's word. That how God, through Christ, made us feel so valuable. And, you know, nothing can discourage us. Nothing can take us down if you will read His word and understand what He's saying to us. So let me read it again. 2 Corinthians chapter 2, verse 14 from the Amplified Bible Classic Edition. It says, "But thanks be to God, who in Christ always leads us in triumph as trophies of Christ's victory, and through us spreads and makes evident the fragrance of the knowledge of God everywhere." So like I shared, you know, we are Christ's trophy. And He proudly puts us on display for His glory. Amen. Not for our glory. See, like I said, you get involved in sports, you win a competition, you have a trophy, you put that trophy on display, not for the glory of the trophy, but for the glory of the one who won the trophy. Amen? So we are God's or Christ's trophy. He won us through His victory over Satan. And we became His trophies, and He puts us on display. He is proud of us. And this is something that we should not argue about. It is God Himself that says that Christ, that we are Christ's trophy. We must believe it. We must accept it. Amen? Amen? Amen. Now, Friday, we had an opportunity. I, myself, my Pastor Jimmy, Pastor Arnell, we had an opportunity to minister to Eagle Scouts of the Philippines. And through Brother Ramon, we were invited. They had a camp at the Jess Camp QB on SBMA. And so we had the opportunity to minister to them. And for those that don't know the Jess Camp has a mini zoo. And so has a zoo with some birds and other animals. And so I started talking to them a little bit about the zoo. And so like any zoo, most animals are in cages. Not all, but most animals are in cages. Why? So that we can watch them without us getting hurt, or so that we don't hurt the animals. Either way, it's for the protection. And, you know, every time we go to these zoos, how many of you have been to a zoo? How many of you have not been to a zoo? There's a zoo right here. So if you've been to a zoo, you know that there's a lot of amazing animals. And we look through those steel barred cages, or we look through glass aquariums and cages, and we stand in awe of God's beautiful creation. We look at the birds. We are amazed at the color. You know, when sometimes you're on SBMA and you would see different birds that you don't see outside. You see them inside because of the forest that we have there. You see them fly by, and the colors are so beautiful. We look at other animals and insects, and we are again amazed at God's creation. We look at the fish of the sea. We observe all of God's creation, and we stand in awe. And so we go through these, you know, we go to the zoo, and we look into these cages or into these aquariums, and you know, we stand there, wow, ang galing. It's just like one time we went to the Ocean Adventure, and before you go to the different shows, you're able to see these different fishes in the aquariums, and it's amazing. The creation of God is so amazing. And so just to give you an idea, just in case you have not seen any amazing creatures, I just went ahead and took some pictures out from the internet just to show you some of God's amazing creature. So let's go ahead. So that's a swan. Maybe you think that's not too amazing, but it is a beautiful creature. Go ahead. Next. See birds like that. Go ahead. Go ahead. Peacock. So talagang ano, when you see a peacock, it's beautiful. Go ahead. So birds again. Another bird. Another bird. An insect. Looks like a branch. I mean, God's creation. God made them that way for a purpose. Go ahead. Looks like a leaf. That is another insect. Can you imagine God created that? So every time, you know, when you see an insect like that, you stand in awe of God's creation. Next. Another insect that looks like a leaf. Another one. I don't know what that is. Next. Go ahead. That looks like, now, go ahead. Yeah. That looks like me. Go ahead. Sige pa. And one more. Fish, I think there's some more. Yeah, another. Let's go back at this fish. This fish, I have a nice story about this fish. Kaminila Albert, Jimmy, and a few other friends of ours, we used to go fishing a lot. And so Pastor Jimmy was the most creative. See, he's an artist. He's the most creative. And so we went to this pier one time on SBMA, and we went fishing. And there was not much fish. We weren't catching much. Jimmy got tired of not catching, and he got tired of the same location that we were normally fishing at. So he goes to a place in the pier where there was a hole. So he puts his fishing line in the hole, and he catches a fish, this fish, that exact fish he caught. And he was so happy. He brings it home, and he cuts all the fins off. And he says, oh, it looks like lapu-lapu when you cut the fins off. So he goes ahead and cooks it. Sometime after, I'm not sure how many, if it's months or a year, like a year after, we go to Ocean Adventure. And this fish was in the aquarium. So I started reading about this fish, and it's the most toxic fish. Now you know why he doesn't smile. Go ahead. Okay, next. Okay, I have a story about this fish. We went fishing again, and this was at El Caballo, and we were fishing. And I caught something, but it wasn't moving. No, normally when you catch a fish, they fight, and you can feel it fight. And I had a big pole, so I was reeling it in. I said, it doesn't feel like a fish. Hindi lumalaban, it wasn't fighting. It feels more like a tire. Parang gulong ng, it was that heavy, I was pulling it in. I finally got it in. It was a puffer fish. It was about that big. Ang laki. And so what I did, we hooked it up somewhere there. And as people were passing by, they would stop kasi ang laki talaga. So I caught that. I didn't eat it. Oh, by the way, that's another toxic fish. You don't eat that. Some people eat that, but they know how to cut it so it doesn't get poisonous. I didn't eat it. We gave it away. Go ahead. So another fish. And by the way, Jimmy caught one time. Who's this? One time we go fishing. Pastor Jimmy catches a fish, and he catches an angel fish and all this. And it's, you know, when you go fishing, you buy shrimp. And sometimes the shrimp that we use to go fishing is more expensive than the fish we catch. And so every fish you catch, big or small, colorful or no color, you eat it. And so we have pangat with angel fish. So these are God's amazing creatures. Okay, let's put it on a blank, so they're not looking at the picture anymore. Anyway, I was thinking of this, and I shared this with the group at the Eagle Scouts. You know, we're going to the zoo, and we're looking into these cages, looking into these aquariums, and we stand in awe. Wow. Ganda. But you know, these animals that are in the cage, these fishes or animals that is behind the aquarium, they're probably looking at us. Wow. Every human being that passed, oh, wow. Diba? Because we are more beautiful. We are more, God created us in His image. And so when we pass by and we're saying, wow. And they're looking at each other, the fishes and the birds, they're talking, wow, what is that? Walks like a monkey, but it's not a monkey, diba? Kind of looks like a monkey, but in there. And so they see us walk by different colors. They see white, they see brown, they see black, they see yellow. They see different outfits, and you know, they see Chinese, they see Filipino. They must be amazed. They must feel that they're going to the zoo, diba? We are God's most precious creation. If you think these animals are awesome and amazing, remember you are God's most wonderful and awesome creation. Why? You were created in the image of God. Amen? No animal, no insect, no fish, no bird was created in the likeness of God. It's only you, us, God's creation, human beings, we were created in God's image. Psalms chapter 1, 3, 9, verse 14. And I like the children's Bible. International Children's Bible says, I praise you because you made me in an amazing and wonderful way. What you have done is wonderful. I know this very well. Amen. It says, I praise you because you made me in an amazing and wonderful way. What you have done. The psalmist is talking to God. What you have done is wonderful. I know this very well. The Tree of Life version says, I praise you for I am awesomely, wonderfully made. Wonderful are your works, and my soul knows that very well. Wonderful. Awesomely, wonderfully made. That's you. Hallelujah. Only one person believes that. That's you. Yeah. Amen. Yeah. For from the voice. I will offer you my grateful heart, for I am your unique creation. Remember, this is a human being talking to God. This is your words to God. I am your unique creation, filled with wonder and awe. You have approached even the smallest details with excellence. Your works are wonderful. I carry this knowledge deep within my soul. Amen. I carry this knowledge deep within my soul. Wherever I go, I carry this. You know, when I go out, I always have a bag. Even when I was in when I was in my 20s, I always liked carrying bags. When bags were not yet uso for men to carry, I was carrying a bag because I like to put everything that's important in one thing so I don't lose it. And so nowadays, you know, you have a bag, you know, I always have my cell phone, I always have my IDs. I always have that because it's important. Now, the psalmist here is saying, I carry this knowledge deep within my soul. Every single day of our lives, every second of our lives, we need to carry this knowledge that you and I are wonderfully and awesomely made. Amen? The Bible says that God made you in an amazing and wonderful way. The Bible says that you are awesomely and wonderfully made. The psalmist says that you are his unique creation, filled with wonder and awe, and that he approached even the smallest details with excellence. He approached the smallest details with excellence. You're not a mistake, amen? You are not a mistake. He says he approached even the smallest details with excellence. This is who you are. You are described as amazing, wonderful, awesome, uniquely made with excellence. And I know this very well. Amen. Is this mayabang? Am I being mayabang when I say, I am uniquely made, I am awesomely made, I am wonderfully made, and I know this? Mayabang ba yun? Is that boastful? Is it? Yes, it is. It's boasting in Him. It's boasting in Him because He created us that way, but it's not boastful on my part because that's how He made me. I'm not saying who I am. I'm saying who He made me. I'm not who I am in myself. I am who I am only because of the grace of God. He says, I am wonderfully, awesomely, uniquely made with excellence. You are God's image bearers. You bear the image of God. Amen. The Bible says you were created in the likeness of God. You are God's greatest, most unique, most awesome, most beautiful creation. Not these fish of the sea, not the birds of the air, not these insects that look so amazing. The most amazing creation is you, because you were created in His own image. Amen. Amen. Imagine that. You were the only one that's made to look like God in His image. Let's read Genesis chapter 1, verse 20 to verse 27 from the New Living Translation. It says, Then God said, Let the waters swarm with fish and other life. Let the skies be filled with birds of every kind. So God created great sea creatures and every living thing that scurries and swarms in the water, and every sort of bird, each producing offspring of the same kind. And God saw that it was good. Then God blessed them, saying, Be fruitful and multiply. Let the fish fill the sea, and let the birds multiply on the earth. And evening passed and morning came, marking the fifth day. Then God said, Let the earth produce every sort of animal, each producing offspring of the same kind, livestock, small animals that scurry along the ground, and wild animals. And that's what happened. God made all sorts of wild animals, livestock, and small animals, each able to produce offspring of the same kind. And God saw that it was good. Verse 26, then God said, let us make human beings in our own image to be like us. They will reign over the fish in the sea, the birds in the air, the sky, the livestock, all the wild animals on the earth, and the small animals that scurry along the ground. So God created human beings in his own image. In the image of God, he created them. Male and female, he created them. So again, the Bible says that you and I were made in the image of God. That's why we are God's most precious creation, that we are awesomely, wonderfully made. Now going back to the animal kingdom, let's read verse 20, verse 25. It says, God created the fish of the sea and the birds of the air and all kinds of animals, livestock, wild animals, insects, etc. And each time God stepped back to look at his creation, he said it was good. So every time God created something, every time he created an animal, he stepped back, he looked at it, he said, it is good. But in verse 26 and verse 27, when God created both male and female, God said, let us make human beings, man, both male and female, in our own image. And again, this is why you, not just we, but you. Because sometimes when you put yourself in generalities, you tend to not believe that you are created so special, but you're just part of a special group. You're part of a special group of people, which is the family of God. But aside from being part of a special group, the family of God, you as an individual, you are God's most amazing creature. You are special. That's why I said animals must be amazed at us, because you are God's image bearer. You bear the image of God. And again, the psalmist says that we must carry this knowledge deep within our heart. We must carry this. And any time and every time anyone or the devil tries to tell you otherwise, remember what the Bible says. You are God's most wonderful creation. Carry it in your heart and soul. And now allow nothing to take this truth away from you. Again, let me read verse 26 of chapter 1, Genesis. Then God said, let us make human beings in our image. God said, and I know we know this, but I'm going to make an emphasis on something, so let's go through it again. God said, let us make man, both male and female, in our image, to be like us. Now, the next part of this message is crucial, and you need to see and understand this. See, many people live their lives as failures and losers in terms of living a righteous life and in terms of fulfilling their purpose. There are many Christians that still don't know their purpose in life. There are still many Christians that fail in living the life that was meant for us to live righteous in Christ. But they are not like that because they were created as losers. God did not create man and women to be losers. God says, I created them in my image and likeness. God is not a loser, amen? God is not a failure, amen? And so God did not create anyone to fail. Different, with different abilities, but not to fail. He did not even create insects and animals to fail. He created them to fulfill a certain purpose and to be successful in that. God created us to succeed in life. He did not create us as losers. He created us amazingly, wonderfully, awesomely, and uniquely made with excellence. The reason why people fail is because we don't believe that. We fail because we don't believe that we were created in his image. We look at ourselves and we say, how can this be the image of God? We believe a lie. And when we begin to believe a lie, that's the way we start to live. Genesis chapter 3, verse 1 to verse 7. We're getting to the crucial part here. The serpent was the shrewdest of all the animals the Lord God had made. One day he asked the woman. So here is Satan using the serpent to tempt Eve. Satan said, did God really say you must not eat the fruit from any of the trees in the garden? Eve answered, of course we may eat fruit from the trees in the garden, the woman replied. It's only the fruit from the tree in the middle of the garden that we are not allowed to eat. God said, you must not eat it or even touch it. If you do, you will die. You won't die, the serpent replied to the woman. God knows that your eyes will be opened as soon as you eat it, and you will be like God, knowing both good and evil. The woman was convinced. She saw that the tree was beautiful, its fruit looked delicious, and she wanted the wisdom it could give her, so she took some of the fruit and ate it. Then she gave to her husband who was with her, and he ate it too. At that moment, their eyes were open, and they suddenly felt shame in their nakedness. So they sewed fig leaves together to cover themselves. Again, remember God said in verse 26, chapter 1, let us make man in our image to be like us. God created man and woman, or male and female, in his image to be like God. When Satan tempted Eve, Satan said this. Satan said, if you eat of the fruit of the knowledge of good and evil, you will be like God. But didn't God just say that I created them in my image to be like me? Diba? Understand. Here is the woman created in the image of God to be like God. And here Satan comes and is tempting her or deceiving her to believe a lie. The lie that Satan is getting her to try to believe is that she was not created in the image of God, and that she had to do something to be like God. I'm going to go back. This is something we need to understand. When Satan tempted Eve, Satan said, if you eat of the fruit of the knowledge of good and evil, you will be like God. So Satan was deceiving Eve to believe that she was not created in the image of God. And this is a deception that Satan continues to try to get us to believe. Because if you will believe a lie that you were not created in the image of God, if you believe a lie that you were created as a failure, that you're created to lose in life, you will lose in life. You will be a failure. If you start to believe that you can never overcome sin because you are the worst person, you will live that way. Satan was deceiving Eve to believe in a lie. What happened next? Eve took the fruit, ate of the fruit. Why? Because she didn't believe in the truth that she was already created in the image of God. She got deceived. When you don't believe that, that's why the psalmist says, and I will carry this deep within my soul. It's something you need to carry with you every day. That you are wonderfully made, that you were created in the image of God, that you are God's image bearer. It's nothing you did, it's something he did in us. And if Satan can get you to believe that you're not created in the image of God, that's the way you're going to live. You're going to live according to what you believe or don't believe. If you believe that you're not created in God's image, you will live the life of a failure. You will live the life of a unrighteous person that can never overcome sin. And that's why took of the fruit, because she didn't believe. She got deceived. So church, we need to understand and believe that God created us in his image and likeness, and carry that in your soul. Growing up, I did not hear much of the word of God, though we were very religious. We went to church often. the Word of God wasn't preached much in the church we went to. So I grew up not believing or believing that I was a failure, because there were many things that I was not good at. I would compare myself to other people. I would compare myself. See, my, you know, my sister, my brother, they were more intelligent than me. And, you know, they would get into these competitions in school. I would always, if you understand, buckle up. I always feared school because I would always do lousy in school. And as I grew older, get into high school, it was just getting worse. To the point where when I was in junior high school, when I was in the States, I did not even show my mom my report card. I hid it because it was that bad. Went to Manila. I struggled because I was trying to become something that I was not. I believed that I saw myself as a loser, not good enough. So I went to college, and the same. I would never show my mom my report cards because I always failed. And that's why I transferred from one course to another, because I was losing. I was failing everywhere. Until I became a Christian, until I started believing in God's word and who He made me to be, I started understanding that, yes, I don't have musical gifts. I'm not your intelligent person. But God put things into my life that was purposely put there for the purpose of my calling, which is I'm a pastor. I remember growing up as a very sensitive person. I would easily get hurt. But God put that in me, so now I become more sensitive to others because I would become a pastor. And so I understand that there are certain gifts and abilities that God put in me. And I no longer have to compete with anyone else because He made me special. In the same way, He made every single one of you special, special in your own way. Special. Don't believe in the lie that you are born loser. Don't believe in the lie just because you came from this family, because you came from this nation or whatever, that because you did not study that you are a failure. God did not create failures. Every single one of you are special, specially made. So when I accepted Christ as my Lord and Savior, my mindset started changing. I started believing in His creation. I started believing that He put something in me special. And I started to do things better. Even as a college student, as a Christian, I started doing better. Although I still struggled in memorizing. I still struggled in school, but I started to believe that God did not create me to be a failure. He created me in His image. He created me. He made me amazing, wonderful, awesome, unique. He made me with excellence. He made me in his image and likeness. And that's how you are made. Every single one of you, bata man o matanda, you are amazingly, wonderfully, awesomely, and uniquely made in excellence, because He, your God, made you. You. Someone saying, you. Amen. In His image and likeness. Let me read that verse and we will end here. Psalms 139, verse 14, International Children's Bible. I praise you because you made me in an amazing and wonderful way. What you have done is wonderful. Hallelujah. Parang you look at yourself, you go to the mirror, and you read this scripture. You're in front of the mirror, and you have not brushed your teeth yet. You have not combed your hair, but you look in the mirror and say, I praise you, God. Wonderful. You look in the mirror again. Wow. And what you have done is wonderful, diba? You look at yourself. See, but you go to the zoo and you, ang ganda, look at the mirror. You made this wonderful thing. Tapos, and I know this very well, diba? Ang yabang, no? And I, alam ko to. Ako to. But that's who you are. That's exactly who you are. That's exactly who we are. Not because of what we did, but because of what He did. Amen? You are God's wonderful image. Believe that. Carry that wherever you go, deep within your soul. Don't believe anything else. And the moment you start believing in that, you'll begin to walk that kind of life. You'll begin to live that kind of life. And you'll not allow anything or anyone to put you down because you are God's image bearer. Amen? You're created in the image of God. Close your eyes with me, church. Ponder upon His message. Ponder upon His words. Meditate upon His words right now. Thank you, Father God. You are wonderfully made. Amazingly made. Uniquely made, excellently made in every detail. Hallelujah. I'm not going to ask you to raise your hand or to come forward, but I want to pray for people that is doubting who they are, doubting that they are not special, doubting that they are not created wonderfully. Because I know many of us, we struggle with that, we fight that, we doubt that. So if you're struggling with in believing that truth that you are wonderfully made, I want to pray for you. Just receive this prayer. This prayer is for you. Father, in the name of Jesus, you know who they are. You know those who struggle, Lord God, with the idea that they are wonderfully made. And I pray, Lord God, in the name of Jesus for them. Lord God, that the word shared today, Lord God, will be planted and rooted in their hearts. And that this word, Lord God, that is planted in their hearts will begin to grow and bear fruit in their lives. That they will begin to believe, Lord God. And that they themselves will see, Lord God, how wonderfully made that they are. And through this, Lord God, that they will begin to live that wonderful life that you purpose them to live, Lord God. Lord, your word also said, Lord God, that you disarmed Satan and every evil one, Lord God, over our lives. Father, I pray, Lord God, in the name of Jesus, that Satan would take his hands off of these people, Lord God, that are believing a lie, Lord God. In the name of Jesus, we pray, Lord God, that you would open the eyes of their understanding, Lord God, to see the light and to receive revelation, Lord God, of your word, of who they are. That they are God's image bearer. You are God's image bearer. You are created in the image of God. I pray, Father God, that they would believe this truth. That they would receive this truth. That they would begin to live according to this truth, Lord God. Father, thank you. We thank you, Lord God. Thank you, Father. Just remain still for a moment. Just remain quiet for a moment with your heads bowed and your eyes still closed.
your heads bowed and your eyes closed, I'm going to ask you to listen for a moment. Especially for those, maybe it's your first time, or maybe you've been here many times, but you don't have a personal relationship with God through Christ Jesus yet. I want you to understand that it is sin that destroys the image of God in us. But like the Bible says, that Jesus came, died for us, so that we may be pronounced not guilty, so that we may have new life. So that the image of God in us can shine through. So if you don't have a relationship with God yet, you have not yet accepted Jesus Christ into your heart, today Jesus wants to come into your life. He wants you to know that you are valuable, you are special, and that through His blood you are pronounced not guilty. The Bible says Jesus knocks at the door of our hearts. On every heart there's a door. And there comes a time in our life when Jesus knocks at that door. He knocks because He wants to come in. He wants to have a relationship with you. He wants to lead you. He wants to guide you. Most of all, He wants you to enter into eternity so that you can live in eternity with Him. And so if you have not yet opened the door of your heart to Jesus, with your heads bowed and your eyes closed, if you want to receive Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior today, if you want to open the door of your heart to Jesus, I'm going to ask that you would raise your right hand so that I can see who wants to accept Jesus. Just raise your right hand if there is anyone here tonight. Madam Ba, thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Is there anyone else? Is there anyone else? Amen. Thank you, Lord. Is there anyone else? I'm going to ask you to do one more thing. Yung mga nagtaas ng kamay, if you can just quietly come here to the front, lumapit lang kayo dito. If you can please come, Margie, my wife will assist you, Marge. Dito kayo. And she will just lead you in a simple prayer to receive Jesus Christ as Lord. You open your heart to Him. Now Jesus is going to come into your life. Church, just keep your heads bowed, your eyes closed, and just be prayerful at this time. Thank you.
Let's give God a clap of praise. Amen. Thank you, brothers and sisters. This is the beginning of something great in your life. Everyone, please stand. Please post again Psalms chapter 139, verse 14, International Children's Bible. Let's read this all together. I praise you because you made me in an amazing and wonderful way. What you have done is wonderful. I know this very well. Say it again. But remember, you are talking to God when you say this. Let's say it again. I praise you because you made me in an amazing and wonderful way. What you have done is wonderful. I know this very well. Amen. Give God a clap of praise for His wonderful creation. Amen. Thank you, Lord. Tonight, as we end our service and give our tithes and offerings, remember, as you give, always give in a form of worship. Give your very best to God because He deserves the very best. After our service, if you still need prayer, we will have some people in the overflow that will pray for you. So just go to the overflow and people will pray for you there. Let's close. Let's pray and let's give our tithes and offerings. Father, again, we offer our tithes and offerings to you. Receive it, Lord God, as we worship you, Lord God, with our offerings. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
The name of Jesus Christ.
Lord God, we thank you again for the message, Lord God, that we are created in your image and that we are beautiful in your sight, Lord God. Father, we thank you as we go home tonight, Lord. We go with your presence, Lord God. And yes, Father, we give you glory and honor. We worship, Lord God. And in this we pray in the mighty name of Jesus. And all God's people say, God bless. Let's close with this song. Remember, you are God's creation, God's image. God created you in His image, and you are beautiful. Hallelujah.